In this module, you will learn about meaning of cash inflow and outflow, various cash inflows and outflows, various formats of maintaining cash register. Let us begin the session with the definition of cash inflow and cash outflow. All the receipts of money are known as cash inflow, and all the payments are known as cash outflow. Let us see some of the examples of cash inflow and cash outflow. For homemaker, money coming from salary is inflow, and money spent on various items is considered as outflow. For a student, pocket money received from parents is inflow, and money spent for various needs is outflow. Here comes the need to understand various ways by which money comes in to the business and reasons for spending the money by the business. Let us start with cash inflow. Some of the ways in which money comes into the business are owner's equity, money invested by the owners of the business, loan received, money borrowed from friends, family, relatives, and bank, sales receipts, money coming in through sale of products or services, interest earned, money coming in the form of interest on the deposits made in the banks or other financial institutions, rent received, money coming in by renting out building or room, sale of assets, money coming in from the sale of leftover property like furniture, machinery, and old car. Claims received. Money coming in from insurance claims like accident claims, fire claims, and maturity of insurance policies. Government subsidy received. Money coming in from grant paid by the government. It is a financial assistance paid by the government to individuals for startups. Sale of scrap. Money coming in from the sale of scrap and waste material and selling rejects. You must note that profit cannot be considered as inflow. Nobody gives money as profit. Profit is the money which is generated in the business. Hence, profit is not to be included as inflow. Next is about cash outflow. There are various ways by which money goes out of the business, such as land, purchasing land to start business, building, constructing a building or purchasing a building to start business, plant and machinery, investing money in plant and machinery to start business, furniture and fixtures, purchasing furniture and fixtures, interior decoration, investing money in hiring an interior decorator, tools, purchasing tools for the business which will be utilized in the business, computers, purchasing computers, raw material, buying raw materials, packing material, money required to buy packing material for products, transportation, purchasing a vehicle to be used for transporting raw materials and transporting the products to the customer's premises, salary and bonus, money paid to employees, employee benefits, perks given to employees like travel allowance and medical benefits, incentives, payment of incentives to employees based on their performance, advertising, money spent on publicizing the products through newspaper, television, pamphlets, brochures, and public hoardings, rent at premises, money being spent on the rent for the premises used for the business, interest on loan, borrowed money on which interest is to be paid, insurance premium, money paid as premium to the insurance company for covering various risks, travel, money spent on traveling for the owners and the employees. Sales commission, money given to the employees or agents as commission on sales. You must note that there are certain assets of the business which are used with longer life, such as furniture and machinery. For these assets, a part of its original value is computed as the cost for a given period, say a month and a year. This is known as depreciation. However, depreciation does not involve the payment of money. Thus, depreciation is not a cash outflow. It is treated as a non-cash expenditure. Next is about recording the cash inflows and outflows. The format of cash register for recording only cash transactions is as displayed on the screen. This is a simplified version compared to what an accountant would use for cash book, in which we have six columns. In this format, the first column is meant to record the date on which the cash is received or paid. The second column is the description in which the details for each received cash or paid cash is entered. The third column is where the bill or voucher details are entered. The fourth column is where the amount of cash received is entered. The fifth column is where the amount of cash paid is entered. The sixth and last column is where the leftover balance is entered. Let us now consider an example. On the basis of the scenario given on the screen, you can fill the respective data in their respective columns in the cash register as shown on the screen. Here, you must note that the balance in the cash register or the cash box does not represent the profit. It only represents the cash balance of the firm. Thus, it is essential to write the cash register for every transaction on daily basis or more frequently to ensure no transaction is being omitted. Let us now look at the format of cash register for recording cash and bank transactions. Here we have 9 columns. It is similar to that of format for cash transaction, other than the fact that it has 3 more additional columns pertaining to the bank transactions. So, here the first 6 columns remain the same as the previous format of recording cash transaction. The 7th column is used to record the amount of money received through check. The 8th column is used to record the amount of money paid through check. The 9th column is used to record the amount of money in the bank, either after receiving or paying the money. Let us now consider an example. On the basis of the scenario given on the screen, you can fill the respective data in their respective columns in the cash register as shown on the screen. Note that when you withdraw money from ATM, it is like issuing a check in the bank. There are 2 entries, check issued and similar amount received as cash. Here, check issued is the outflow from bank and amount received as cash is the inflow into the cash box. Similarly, when you withdraw money from the bank or deposit in the bank, there are 2 entries made, one in cash column and the other in check column. These entries are called as contra entry. You can consider this as taking money from one pocket and putting it in another pocket. Money does not go anywhere. It will still remain with the owner. Only thing is, it changes from cash box or bank account. Next is credit transactions. In business at times, the products are sold on credit. It implies that the buyer does not pay the cash immediately. Rather, will pay at a later date. This practice in business is known as selling on credit. Buying on credit implies that the buyer will purchase a product from a seller but will not pay the seller immediately. Rather, buyer makes the payment at a later date. This is known as buying on credit. However, in cashbook, we do not enter any credit transactions, whether given or taken. But from the business perspective, it is very important for an entrepreneur to keep track of these and make appropriate entries in the cashbook. Thus, in order to help this problem, a simple format as shown on the screen is essentially helpful. It will also help in tallying or reconciliation of the transactions. It is suggested for the entrepreneurs to keep as much transactions in cash and not give too much credit. Otherwise, the entrepreneur has to spend more time in collecting credit and losing money when the creditors don't pay. In this module, you have learned all the receipts of money are known as cash inflow and all the payments are known as cash outflow. There are certain assets of the business which are used with longer life, such as furniture and machinery. For these assets, a part of its original value is computed as the cost for a given period, say a month and a year. This is known as depreciation. When money is withdrawn from the bank or deposited to the bank, there are two entries made, one in cash column and the other in check column. These entries are called as contra entry. In business, at times, the products are sold on credit. It implies that the buyer does not pay the cash immediately, rather, will pay at a later date. This practice in business is known as selling on credit. Buying on credit implies that the buyer will purchase a product from a seller but will not pay the seller immediately. Rather, buyer makes the payment at a later date. This is known as buying on credit.